Hello everyone, in this video we will see how to easily create this glitch effect that you can see in here using Adobe Photoshop. But before we're gonna do that, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like. Alright, so let's get to it. Alright, so let's go ahead and open Photoshop, and then I will go and open the image I will be using for this. Alright, so the first thing that we have to do is to cut the model from the background. So I will go to Object Selection and I will choose Select Subject. Alright, as you can see, because we have a white background, it makes a really decent selection. So I will go and choose Select and Mask, and I want to smooth out the edges, so I'm gonna put 50 in the smooth and maybe 2 pixels in the radius, and I will check smart radius in here, and that will be all. So I'm gonna press OK, and then I'm gonna apply layer mask, and I will name this to model. After that I will right click and convert it to smart object. Alright, now I'm gonna create another background for this, so we'll go and choose solid color, and I want actually to put like 10% brightness to have this dark gray in here, and I will put it under or below the model. Alright, now this is basically a very straightforward glitch effect, and the only thing that it will be different is I want to actually to apply the glitch only on one side and leave the other one intact. It's more like a dispersion kind of effect or a decay, but this time using glitches. Alright, and to do that it's actually quite simple. We're just gonna do the usual RGB split and apply a filter. So let's go and apply the filter first. So I'm gonna press Ctrl Command J to make a copy, and let's call this glitch. Alright, next I will go to filter and I will choose distort, and I will choose wave. Now for this wave, it's actually very simple to use. Just, you know, keep playing with the numbers. The only thing that you have to do when you are using this for a glitch is to change the type to square, because it will work best. As you can see, if I change the amplitude, you can see how it goes, like in a square in the vertical and the horizontal. Alright, so let's actually start with the generator. I recommend to keep the generator under 5, because the more you go, the more it will be vanished all over the place. So between 2 and 5, I think it's the best number to go. For me, I would keep it 5. And the other thing that we have to control is the scaling of this. Because I want the glitch to be on the side in a horizontal way, I don't want to use the vertical. So I'm just gonna keep the vertical 0. And I'm going to only use the horizontal when it comes to scaling. As you can see, the more I go up, the more the image it will move to the other side. So for now, we'll keep it 60%. And then I will go and play with the amplitude. As you can see, if you want it to move in this side, or you want it to be a little bit close to the center, for me, I would keep it around here, maybe around 400. Maximum, and then I will go and play with the wavelength. Now this is where all the distortion will happen. As you can see, if you want it to be a bigger wave, you can control the minimum and the maximum. For me, I will keep it around 300 to 400, so let's actually put 400 and the minimum something like 50. And the other thing that you can do is actually to click on this randomize, and it will give you different results. As you can see, it's actually quite interesting when it's a little bit random. Alright, so something like that, I think it will be okay, and I'll press okay. Now the other cool thing about this is we have it as a smart object. You can always go back and double click on this wave filter, and you can always go back and, you know, change the numbers in here and play with it even more. All right, but I think I'm gonna stick with this. All right, now I will go back to the model layer and I'm gonna apply a layer mask, and then I will go to the gradient. And as you can see, I have white is my foreground color, and because we have a white layer mask, we need actually to have black if you want to hide from the layer mask. So I'm just gonna change the foreground color to black, and then in the gradient, make sure that you are selecting color to transparent, the second one in the basic folder. And also for the style, make sure that you have linear gradient. All right, now we'll make sure that I'm selecting the layer mask, and then I will go to this side and I will one click and drag just like that to start the layering from this side, as you can see. All right, now I will go back to the glitch layer and I will apply again a layer mask, and I will do basically the same, but this time I will go from this side. So I will one click and drag just like that, and there we go, we have one side that is touch and the other one is intact. Now we're gonna fix this a little bit more using a brush. So I will go and press B on my brushes, and I'm gonna choose a simple brush, and I will start deleting with the areas that I don't want to be having any glitches. For example, I want a part of the eye in here and a little bit of the mouth, just like that. And then I will go back to the model layer and I will do the same. And I will do the same using white as foreground color this time, because I want to bring back to the image, just like that. And I will delete a little bit from this part and a little bit in here. All right, so I think I'm happy with this. Now I will select the glitch layer that we have in here, and I'm gonna make two copies of it. So I'm gonna press Ctrl Command J twice, and then I will name this RGB 1 and the other one RGB 2. All right, so I will hide this RGB 2 for now, and then I will select RGB 1 layer, and I will go to this FX icon and I will choose blending options. Now I'm gonna go to this advanced blending where it said channels in here, and I'm gonna uncheck the green and the blue. This will only leave the red color, and I will press OK. Now using my move tool, I will take this red and I will put it a little bit in this side in here, just like that. Now we'll go to the RGB 2 and make it visible, and I will do the same. I will go to this FX icon and I will choose blending options, and for this one I'm gonna hide or uncheck the red and uncheck the green, and I will only leave the blue in here, and I'm gonna press OK. Alright, so I will do the same using my move tool. I will drag it a little bit to this side, and this is depend on your preference, you can move it wherever you want, but for me I like this kind of red in here appearing in this side too. All right, so we're almost done. Now the only thing that we have to do is to apply some textures and also some adjustment. So I will go and open the texture that I will be using, which is this one. So I will take it and open it in the same tab, and I'm gonna scale it to fit just like that. All right, now for this I'm gonna change the blending mode of it to like soft light, I think. Yeah, and then I'm gonna apply a layer mask, and I will do basically the same for this. So I'm gonna make sure that I'm selecting the layer mask, and then I will go to the gradient, and we have black as foreground color, which means that we can hide from the layer mask. So we'll go again to this side and I will one click and drag just like that to hide all these glitches that we have in here. All right, so I will go back to my folder and I'm gonna open the other texture, and again I'm gonna scale it to fit just like this. Now I'm gonna change the blending mode of this to, let's see, maybe overlay. Yeah, let's keep it overlay, and I'm gonna drop down the opacity a little bit to have that really nice TV kind of look, and I think it looks really cool. Now there is another trick that you can do, is to actually make a stem visible layer by pressing Control Shift Alt E altogether, or Command Shift Option E altogether. And this will basically make a stem visible layer, or it will take a screenshot from what you have in your canvas. As you can see, let's call it stamp. Now we're gonna go and choose the rectangle or marquee tool, and I'm gonna start making some rectangles like that. Now I have the rectangle marquee tool set to add to selection, which means I can make a selection next to another. As you can see, I have this plus icon, so I'm just gonna make a bunch of them. Well, I think this will be enough. So while I'm selecting this stamp layer, I'm gonna press Ctrl Command C to copy it, and then Ctrl Shift or Command Shift V to paste it in place. Now I will hide the stamp layer, and I'm gonna press Ctrl Command T, and I will move this a little bit to the other side, just like this. Alright, as you can see, just to give it a little bit of glitching edges in this part too. Now you can go as much as you want for this, but for me, I think I will keep it like this. I think it looks really cool. Alright, now the next thing that we can do is actually to place this copy that we have. We're gonna place it under the textures that we have, just to have the difference between the textures and those selections. Alright, next I will go to adjustments, and I will choose color local. Now let's go and find something a little bit warm for the skin. Yeah, I think this crisp, warm look, it will be interesting, but I don't like how it makes all the black a little bit exaggerated. So let's go and open the blending options, and then we can actually fix that using the underlying layer in the blend if. So I'm gonna press Alt or Option, and I will one click on this slider, and it will split it. So I will move it a little bit, just for me to see a little bit of the grayish color that we have turned back, maybe around 100, and I'm gonna press OK. I think it's still a little bit strong, so I'm gonna drop down the opacity just a bit. Alright, and there we go. So I hope that you enjoy and you like this quick tutorial, and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment, and you know, wait for more tutorials to come, and have a nice day. Thank you for watching.